Greetings and welcome to Let's Play Bard's Tale, Tales of the Unknown. We are still in Scarab Way, we are still in our farming route, but soonish my party will be able to survive a little bit more. The thing is, I checked out the CRPG addict, he did play this game, and he said he spent grinding in Scarab Way until his party was level 7. Thieves. Okay, let's fight thieves. I am 100% certain I won't record all of this. So let's get the party, at least the mages, to level 2. And then I will grind off screen. Maybe I do a stream where I record this, but yeah, that would be a little bit redonkulous. Okay, they don't seem to like Will, but they don't have a lot of hit points, so that's something. Fight. Attack all the foes. I like it that attack, foes, and defense is in one row, so we can easily... 82 pieces of gold! Wow! And Gilvan the Third found an item. Okay, exit. I mean, there were 4 videos of grinding where I didn't even make it to level 2. And going up to level 7, yeah, how about no, how about no? I know this video, and then we will see each other as soon as I'm level 7 or so, and we can actually survive in the sewers, because apparently in the sewers, like I said, you have like multiple groups of enemies, and when you can barely fight one group, and then suddenly you have to defeat 3 of them at the same time, But from what I've gathered, as soon as you survive the initial grind, the game is at least bearable. The dungeons themselves are quite hard. I'm not sure yet if I want to... if I want to use maps already for the dungeons or not, but we will see. We will see how this turns out. I also checked the War Axe does 2d4 damage, and the Halberd is 1d16. So it's kind of sad that you get a quite potent weapon already in the first shop. It's quite weird, you know. But oh well. Nothing we can change. We just have to do the grinding. It's weird that they have absolutely no sound effects. I checked the settings. They are all fine. I mean, we do get sound effects when I die. I just don't know why there are different songs on the OST, huge quotation mark, for the different Bard songs, but it doesn't play. Stop focusing on Gilvan. That's mean. That's the bad thing. The enemies can just go and focus one of your party members down and you can't do anything about this. Oh, Gilvan is dead. Of course. Oh well. Considering we are going... I actually read about this. Hunters get the ability to critical strike later on. And I think critical strikes instantly kill enemies. So that is something. So maybe I'd make Gilvan the Fourth a... don't go into the buildings. Maybe I make Gilvan the Fourth a hunter. So we have a little bit of diversity in our party. Oh, Well, guys, we have another corpse. Hello. Can somebody please take care of this? Okay, one trade with Tim. One trade with Tim. Oh yeah, and the mace and the short sword do the same amount of damage. It's just that one is more expensive because more classes can use it, which is quite weird. But oh well, pool gold. Oh, 3,000 gold. Well, we can create a nice. Why does Tim have more AC? I think because of sinking AC. We will let make an elf. I want lots of strengths, lots of. Maybe the elf doesn't get such high strength points. Let's make a dwarf, nobody cares. Go on, give me 18 or 19 and good strengths. That's bad dexterity, still bad dexterity. Come on, come on! Now a little bit more. What more? It's worse than what I had, but I guess I have to deal with that hunter. Gilvan the Fourth. We move Tim. We move Nianu. We move Gawair. Add Gilvan. Gawair, Nianu, and Tip. Like I said, sooner or later, maybe one of these will turn into a caster. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure if I want this. We will see. Maybe if someone dies and I have a reason to do this. But then again, later on, I mean, theoretically, we could have resurrected Gilvan the Third, but I wasn't a big fan of the rogue, anyways. Give you a lamp. Nianu had an item. Can I switch like that? No, of course not. Let's make it as complicated as possible. Oh, that was just the item. Yeah. We can let Boltak identify this. So, equip. So, let's see what the hunter can actually wield equipment-wise. Oh, yeah. Pool gold. Like I said, with the functionality that enemies can steal from someone, the pool gold thing kinda makes sense, but I'm still not a big fan of it. I don't know, it's just maybe a mix. Maybe have, but then again, it makes it useless. You know, if you had like one person has all the gold, but when you buy and sell stuff, it takes the party gold. But then you would just say, okay, Tim is the gold keeper, so I don't know. Buy. Can you get a halberd? Yeah. You just can't have plate armor, okay? Then you get scale armor. You get a helm. You should have leather gauntlets already. You get a tower shield. And you are out of inventory. Let's sell the buckler and buy the halberd. Done. Exit. Oh, well, it's cheaper than buying resurrecting. Equip. 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 And then we can sell the rest, identify the one item, and everyone is happy. Happy! Gilvan, sell leather armor. Sell mace. And I think it was Niano. No, that's looking at Niano. Trade to Gilvan. Pretty sure it's a torch or a lamp or something. Identify an item. Item. And it's a lamp, yeah. I guess on the amount of what it sells for, you can see. Let me save real quick. Bard's Tale. Yes, Overwhite. Wonderful. Let us heal everyone and then we are ready for... Oh! Three conjurers. Oh, well, that should not be a problem. Hopefully. Yeah. Oh, 2 points of damage. That's not much. Because later in the game, as you can see, one melee character can only kill one enemy. But your mages later on, they get like area of effect spells that hit a whole group. They get area of effect spells that hit all of the enemies and stuff like that. So, yeah, later on the casters really, really lay down the smack. And the melees are kind of just there to take the damage. Maybe they can do some high hits, so maybe melees are good for bosses. But there's also something I have to check out, because it was in the version that the CRPG addict had. Okay, let's try it in a combat. I faced two nomads. Fight? No. It seems to be only... Okay. He said that if you hit the Z or Y button, that it summons a stone golem. But apparently not here. Nomads are really bad for gold, considering they share the same picture as the barbarian. So I guess they have the same class of monster or so. That's really bad. Empty building. 7 barbarians! No! 1. Oh, fuck. Defend. Can I run multiple times? Wait a second. No, that's attack. Attack, attack, attack. Bard song. Traveler's tune. Cast a spell. Arcfire. Barbarians. Cast a spell, Warple Plating on Gilvan. Yes. 7 points of damage, oh god. Yes, yes. Oh, Will is dead. No, the focus on Samuel. 16 points of damage. Yeah, how about we just immediately load? How about this? Sounds like a swell idea, or yeah, I also thought so. That sounds good. Yeah, we can face two. No, oh god, is this seeded or so? Will my next party always be the 9 barbarians? I'm pretty sure back in the day they didn't use seeds to do that. Or maybe they just did that because it's the same amount of experience in gold, if I remember correctly. Oh god, we're so fucked. Let's go somewhere else. Maybe that resets the seed or so. Let's go to the board of assholes. Advancement. Tim. 253 more experience points. Okay. Soon we have our first level 2 characters. Gawair needs even more experience. Gawair never died, or? Maybe Bards needs more experience points for some reason than fucking sorcerers. Because Because being a bard is such harsh life. Where is the tavern? Gawair needs his drink. Scabbabuella. You can order a drink. Who will drink? Gawair. He will have an ale. Not bad. Okay, exit. I don't know if you can actually get drunk in this game. But, oh yeah, pressing back turns the party around. Shocking, I know. So, please no barbarians. Please no barbarians. Even two barbarians would not be manageable, because if both of them hit the same person, they're dead. Barbarians are just such a bullshit enemy. So, I need a few more fights. And I have to get those people up to level 7. I don't know if the enemies scale somehow with your level. But getting to level 7 will be... Oh god, there will be lots of fun, quotation mark. Maybe I don't have to go to level 7. I mean, just because the... oh god, magicians. Magicians are bad because they can wither you and you don't want that. Okay. Swing at will all you want. That's fine. Do they at least give lots of experience points? No. Add not a lot of gold. I mean, like I said, just because the CRPG addict did it to level 7 doesn't mean I need to. Maybe we can grind in the first level of the sewers or so. That would be swell. Will needed the healing, and he shall pay for it himself. And he's healed. Wonderful. Three mercenaries. Well, let's fight them. Should die in one turn, maybe? Yes! Oh, 8 points of damage, it's a lot. But at least with the halbards, we 110 experience points, that's not bad. Did we already have the experience points we need for Jim? How much experience points do you have? No, guess he still needs a little bit more. I think as soon as my backward characters are level 2, I will start resurrecting my characters, because after that it just takes too long for them to level up. We have enough gold, so unless we have like a really bad party vibe. I mean, it's not even done just because those in the back row are level 2 that we are done. Because at level 3 they get their healing spells. I need to check out if there's a good grinding spot or so. Maybe there's an enemy you can always trigger that is defeatable. 8 points of damage. That's rough. That's really rough. God, you really don't want to fight more than 3 of these at once. And they barely give experience too. Can I kill some hobbits or so? Some hobbits, please? Anyone? Zelt needs healing, will pay. And he's healed. Wonderful. I think Nianu and Tim should have their max spell points by now, because I'm not really using a lot of spells, which is good. So it does regenerate on its own. I guess later on you need Roscoe's 7 barbarians. 1. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Let's save. Let's save quickly. And the game reminds you to 8 dwarves. Okay. We can do this, hopefully. Use the Bard Song Traveler's Tune, cast a spell Arcfire, cast a spell Vorpal Plating. Yes. Dwarves aren't that high level, and we should be able to just survive them because they don't seem to be able to hit. Tim cast a spell, okay. My front row has 0 AC now, which is good because we are still living in this world where less AC is better than high AC. Because fuck you, that's why. Fight, attack, attack, attack. Defend, cast arc fire on the dwarves. Oh god, 8 points of damage on Will. Oh, they start hitting. They start hitting people. That's not good. That's not good. Can you stop that? Can you stop hitting, please? Yes, kill more dwarves. That's the spirit. Only 4 more dwarves left. Okay. Why did Gilvan not attack? Nianu. Arc fire. You cast a spell Vorpal Plating on Will. So he has more. Oh, Will is dead. Oh well, we can resurrect him. He can be resurrected. Yay! He has minus 1 AC and is dead. Gawair chops at a dwarf for 2 damage. Yes, hit Gawair a little bit. He can take it. Okay, I guess that were all. Dwarves give lots of gold if I remember correctly. No, they don't. Not at all. It wasn't even worth the experience points, to be quite honest. That was a. Let's reload. Load state. Okay, that was too much of a loss. Can we level? Do I need to pay for leveling up? I don't know. I hope not. Because that would suck really hard. Advancement. Tim. 94 experience points. Okay. Okay, we can do this. We can get this. 8 kobolds. That should be doable. Fight. Kill Bard Song. Traveler's Tune. Cast Arcfire. Kobolds. Defend. Yes. Gawair plays a tune. Okay. Stop hitting people. Will, you need to do more damage. We need to kill them with one hit. Yes, look at Zelt. He does it correctly. Oh, Gilvan gets hit. They are whittling me down. Yes, look at Gilvan. Look at Gilvan. She does it correctly. Attack, attack, attack. Defend. It's quite weird that there are no ranged weapons, you know? I checked it. Apparently, there aren't. Maybe I should have started the game with like 2 melees, a bard, and 3 casters. Oh well. I mean, the bard. I think later get some music instruments that do damage or have some effects. So maybe that's the role of the bard later on. Just be like this thing. 160 gold, and Will found a chainmail. Okay, that was worth it. That's one resurrection. Just. I think. Oh, 3 spiders. The denizens of this mystic place assault you. Okay. This mystic place that is the streets of Scarabray. Or more like Scarabay. Okay. We killed the spiders, so Tim can. Will found a weapon. Okay. Maybe it will be a useless axe again. So, advancement, Tim. The guild leader's name, Tim, has earned a level of advancement, plus 1 to H IQ. Okay, so Nianu also. Dexterity, wonderful, just what she always needed. Gawair, 139 points of experience, okay. And Gilvan, 1596. Ah, Sir Samuel, 1366. And Will, 1366. Oh. Spell acquiring, Tim. Doe cannot acquire new spells yet. You fuckers. Gawair didn't even get a level so he could, cast two songs at the same time. I think later on he gets like equipment that lets him sing unlimited bard songs, which would be great. Okay, now I just need to get alive to the temples. We can do this. We can do it. Yes! We made it! Will pay. Hundred gold. That's what we got from the fucking goblins. Okay. Let's identify the weapon that we got. And then we will, I don't know, quiet ourselves a bit. Do I see how many spell points you have? 15, okay. Oh, we get attacked by giant spiders in front of the weapon shop. Maybe they just came out, bought some guns because we're America. Yes, Gamma Boy is actually America. For those who didn't know, they're always giant spiders. Just waiting outside to attack you. And then they would be in Australia. Yeah. Can you not kill Gilvan, please? I would appreciate that. Ah, my bottle that I've been drinking. Oh, not a bad experience. Not bad gold. Scarabée. So, somebody found a weapon, right? Yes. 10. Okay, that can't be something. And it's a dagger. Ooh. Yeah, 5,000 gold. That's something. Sell item, you have nothing of interest. We keep the lamps in case we need them. Yeah. So from what I've gathered, you also don't find like the shop doesn't stock up, let's say it this way. So that what we've got from the shop now is that what we well get from the shop. Which means that every piece of equipment we need as an upgrade has to be found from monsters or treasure chests in the dungeons, which is bad. Really, really bad. Oh well. Will you get all the gold? And you pay for the heal. Well, oh, Gilvan also needs healing. He will pay, the priest lay hands on him, and he is healed. Luckily, it's not like wizardry. Oh, the priest lay hands on him, and he's eradicated. That would be quite sad. Okay, as I'm going to end the part here. Like I said, this is the last time I'm uploading grinding. I will do a stream. I will link to the video, in the next video of the grinding, and then you guys can enjoy the actual game when we encounter the first dungeon. Okay. I thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And we will see each other soon. So take care and hit the like button.